Most people in life are looking at how do I make a life worth living in retirement with having, but the question I have to ask to these abusers of my life and video channel is, why are you doing this? What exactly do you benefit from by doing this? How exactly are you helping your own life and your own situation for doing this? Are you just getting off on the power of it, or do you get some sort of financial benefit from someone who's paying you to do this? And if they're paying you to do this, why are they paying you to do this? Are they paying you to do this so they can fucking rape my potential wife? Or are they paying you to do this because you like to abuse people? Or are they paying you to do this because you think Christ is in you? Now, if I use inappropriate language, I sort of have the right to do this because under the First Amendment of the United States, we have freedom of speech. But the one thing that sort of bothers me the most about these talk shows like The View and even just a video that I was just trying to listen to by a guy who I really kind of regard and like, who's Howard Stern, and it's not that I agree with all of his ways of doing things, but I do like the fact that he's really had to earn his way into the populace. But what I can say to you is, I don't get it. I don't get when people are asked the question why the fucking interviewer never shuts up and lets the interviewee answer the fucking question. I don't get why those people want to keep asking the fucking question over and over and over again to the point that the guy's like, just shut up and let me answer you. What I see is rudeness. What I see is a policy of rudeness, a policy of police, a policy of government, a policy of Christians, a policy of Muslims, a policy of foreigners in our American continent of rudeness. That you think that because it's COVID, you can walk right next to me without moving out of the way when I'm already here to stay. You should be at 6 feet when you walk around a total stranger, and you need to do that today. But when we're in the midst of conversations, we need to be able to ask the question, and then the person needs to shut up and listen. We learned this from the late Steve Shapiro, and even though there's another Steve Shapiro out there, he's not the guy that I'm talking about. Steve Shapiro, who did that marvelous audio talk for my international network marketing organization, has died. But one of the best things that I did for myself every quarter was always re-listen to his CD. And for some reason, those CDs have been stolen from me. Why? Some reason my video camera and my trail cameras have been stolen from me in my storage unit. Why? Who the fuck went into those places and did that? But let me ask you, what gives you the right to do that? What is it that you're thinking? What is it that you're processing? What is it that you're linking in your mind that says, I have the right to steal? I have the right to taint? I have the right to abuse? I have the right to, what, faint if I make a rhyme? No. What is it that you think you're doing to me? What is it that you're gaining from harassing my life, ruining my videos? And that video was like 2 minutes and now it's like five? Give me a fucking break. I'm not asking you to sling together videos from my computer. I choose what I'm going to use. God chooses for me what I'm going to use. I don't need you ever choosing for me. No one in this world is asking you to choose for them. That is the one aspect of freedom we have in America. You can make your choices, and you can. But if you choose wrong, that's on you. If you choose not to learn how to access your angels to help you choose better in life, that's on you. If you choose not to have a faith, that's on you. But if you choose to abuse people, violate the law, ruin your own life because you thought you had it all, that's on you.